Joining us now is Marc Weissman. Marc has been a lifelong New York Ranger fan for over 44 years, and he's watched Messier almost his entire career. Marc, what impact did Messier have on you and the people around you?
Well, I think the first thing that comes to mind when I think of Messier is the way he came to New York, you know, having already won 5 Stanley Cups, and, you know, the entire city was really possessed by this curse of 1940 and having gone 54 years. And what I loved about the fact that he basically dismissed everything, came in and said, you know, there's no such thing as jinxes or curses, and we have to just stare in the face. And with each successive win, each playoff round in 94 that he won, you know, it became more and more obvious that he was leading not only by example, but with the way he conducted himself and this lack of fear of, you know, this supposed curse that had hovered over the team for so long. And I think personally that's actually inspired me. I mean, ever since 94, you know, my superstitions and jinxes and curses and belief and all that has pretty much gone out the window because of what Messier and the team that year did. And no longer am I worried about, you know, what I wear that particular day or things like that. It's just all about the game and the players and how they play and you know, basically hoping for the best for everyone and obviously being very excited about what's going on.
Do you think when Messier showed that kind of leadership that it was universal, that it went across all lines, regardless of what fan or what team you were on? Do you think that him leading that example had a profound impact not only on New Yorkers but people who humanity in general?
Oh, absolutely. I think so. I mean, he's been called the leader, not just the greatest leader in all of hockey, but in all of, you know, professional sports. I mean, people understand, you know, the fact that day in and day out, the example he sets in the locker room, you know, things he does off the ice. A lot of people may not even realize that, you know, there's a children's hospital in Hackensack, New Jersey that actually named a skyway after him. He visits kids there, you know, and while they're having blood tests and, you know, signs an autograph or gives them a, you know, a token of appreciation, maybe a stick or things like that. And there's a whole skyway of memorabilia from his entire career, not just his Ranger career, you know, in the metro New York area. And I think that speaks volumes about what he means to the community, you know, over and above what he means to hockey fans or sports fans or even Ranger or Edmonton fans in particular.
So if there was one thing you think that humanity altogether could actually fundamentally learn from Marc Messier, for the example Marc Messier leads, sets, what would you say that would be?
I think I would say that would be one thing that he said. He said, if you want to achieve something that's never been achieved before and you want to set your goal, always set your goal even higher than what you think can be accomplished. And because when you shoot for that goal, you may not have things that, you know, you may not get to that goal immediately. You may have setbacks along the way. But the point is to strive as high as you possibly can and then some. And then you will ultimately reach the original goal that you have. I think that's what he did in Edmonton, where he grew up, 5 Stanley Cups there, wanted to change, came to New York, stared down everything. And he continues to do that, you know, in the community. And, you know, as a Hockey Hall of Famer, you know, he's an example for everyone, both, you know, in professional sports and outside.
Okay. Marc Weissman, thank you so much for your great analysis. Really appreciate it.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it.